Mother Nature offers us all the facilities to lead a comfortable and peaceful life. She brings us rain, she feeds the human beings who are her children, she feeds the animals also who are also her children. The complete environment in which we live is nature. Yet we humans are not grateful to nature. We pollute the surroundings and bring destruction onto ourselves. Environmental pollution is one of the greatest dangers for mankind in this century. But humans are responsible for pollution. By this, we not only harm ourselves, but the millions of species living on Earth. Due to global warming, all the water bodies are vanishing or either getting depleted. All freshwater sources are drying up. We are running short of fresh water. We speak a lot about it. We speak a lot about renovating ourselves, but we fail to find where we are lagging behind and where we actually must find the solution. Today, in Bangalore city, there is a huge water crisis. It is said that Bangalore was called the city of lakes in India. Well, that was almost 100 years ago. Now, no, we can't call our city like that. If all these lakes had been there, there would have been no water crisis at all the city that is facing now. Then, where did all these lakes go? Is the government alone responsible for this? The answer is definitely a big no. We humans too must contribute, civilians must contribute and work along with the local government for the development of these lakes. Now, for example, we choose the Doddabommasandra Lake to express our concern about our city's vanishing lakes. This beautiful lake was once a lifetime for the people living in this region. Once upon a time, since the past 10 years, the water levels in this lake depleted almost the threshold level. That is, they dried up completely. The civic authorities and the people living here, instead of renovating it, neglected it. Today, almost everyone living around the lake use it for their solid waste disposal. Sewage from the urbanized area around this lake is being let inside this lake, because of which the aquatic animals living in the last level of water are dying, and also the water is getting contaminated and unfit for any work. There were also migratory birds that had always been visiting this lake during summer. Well, not only this lake, but all the other lakes in Bangalore too. But now, because of pollution and non-availability of water in these lakes, they have become a prized asset to see. That is, they are not to be seen at all. The only way to save our lakes from becoming completely extinct is to stop entry of sewages into our lakes. The government must bring a strict and proper garbage disposal system so that residents are not forced to dispose their garbage and other solid waste in these lakes. The lakes must be properly maintained by desilting often, removing weeds on recurring timely basis. If the lake water becomes pure, they can be used for solving drinking water problems of the surrounding areas. This is one of the many lakes in Bangalore that will probably remain only in the government record books in nearly just 5 years. This lake is spread across 8 acres approximately. Once upon a time, there used to be water filling this lake up to a height of around 50 feet. Now, not even a single feet of water is there. Well, however, when it rains heavily, the water level rises to around 20 centimeters. The lake ecology is an important aspect to be considered. When the ecology of the lake is affected, its cycle is also affected. That is, the plants, the animal species, including us, are affected in many ways. We need to tackle this problem soon, or our lakes will be history. Generally, this lake is so dry that kids are now using this lake as a playground. Rumors were also afloat that the government was considering to build a bus terminus on this lake. At the same time, there were also other rumors that they were planning to build a park out of this place. Instead of this, what we found could be feasible is to declare that this area is a restricted zone. Since the lake is a reservoir, there'd be water catched during rainy season. The catched water can be treated and purified at the same place. Restricting people by fencing or any other suitable methods will reduce garbage dumping and pollution of the water. The treated water can be then used to supply drinking water to the surrounding areas. If every small town had a lake, and if these lakes are maintained clearly, cleanly, the water woes of our city can be easily solved. Recently, the BWSSB is said to have been planning to build 6 artificial lakes in Bangalore city to quench the thirst of all the 198 wards of Bangalore. But shouldn't the lakes that already exist be regenerated first? Many of the lakes that we have are artificial, and the government should first give them a lease of life and then look into building new lakes. Civilians must join hands with local governments and private organizations to save our last existing lakes that are on the verge of extinction. Well, they say it's never too late to start. Let's join hands to save our lakes. Finally, we thank the Indian Water Portal for giving us this wonderful opportunity to highlight the poor condition.